Last class we
Right.
discussed, are able to see my screen, sir?
Yeah, I can see your screen. Yeah.
Okay, so last class we discussed with data modeling, how to connect the database, how to import the tables. Once import the tables, how to establish the joins, calculate fields, okay, synthetic tables, synthetic keys, all the things we discussed. Any queries under that one, sir?
No, no, I'm okay.
Okay, now we'll go to the today we'll go to the first. We'll discuss with sheet objects. We'll discuss with sheet objects. So we have 15 sheet objects and 13 charts. Total 28 objects are there. Total 28 objects are there. Yes, we can use that 28 object. How to use it? I'll show you. So first we'll discuss with individually. Okay, individual. First 15 sheet objects, then 13 charts. Then we'll go to the using that 28. We need to build the dashboards one by one. We'll go ahead. So first thing, we'll go to the sheet objects. Yes, so this is the main page. So you need to see the table structure. We are imported. These are the five tables. We are imported. These are the five tables. We are imported. These are the five tables. Okay, if you want to see the script, so any modification if you want required, go to the control E. Go to the control E. You can see the script. Okay, any script, these things already you know, right? Now by default, the main page was by default was came. Okay, here. So yes, first we'll go to the basics. You can add the n number of sheets. This is the document name or dashboard name. This is the first sheet. So this is the, by default it was came. So you can add it. You can add sheet. You can add the n number of sheets. You can add the n number of sheets. Each sheet will go to the properties. So yes, one ID was generated. Okay, if you want to change the name, you can change the name here each sheet. So the ID was generated. So SH01. So the ID was generated, SH01 main. As you can see now, the ID was generated, SH01. Yes, this is the first sheet. So this is the main name. Any name you can give it here as a sample. If you want record, you can give it or anything. So each, so go to here. Yes, properties. Yes, sheet properties. Yes, this is the sheet 2. Yes, unique ID was generated. Sample. Okay, sample. Yes, you will go to the sheet 2, sheet 3 and sheet 4. Yes, you will go to the one by one. Right. Now, so we'll see the what are the sheet objects. We have several sheet objects are there. So go to the new sheet objects. List box, statistics box, multi box, table box, chart, input box, current selection box, button, text object, line and arrow, slider and calendar object, bookmark, search object, container. So these are all right. We have 15 sheet objects and 13 charts are there. Yes, first we'll discuss with the sheet objects, then we'll go to the charts. So all the things, if you know, then using these objects, you know how to build the dashboard. How to build the dashboard and server. One by one, we'll go ahead. Right, first we'll go to the list box. A list box is a, what is the a list box? A list box is a default sheet object. So default sheet object, it allows only single dimension or a single column. It will display the values uniquely. So 3 points. A list box is a default sheet object. So it allows only single dimension or single column. It allows single dimension or single column. And the third point is it will display the unique values. It will display the unique values. Yes. Now I'll go to the list box. Yes. Click on the list box. Yes. Here, so we have, so several tabs are there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Last 4 tabs are, it will same for all the sheet objects. Last 4 tabs are same for all the sheet objects. Okay. Almost last 4. Okay, so first sheet, so we'll go to the here general tab, we'll discuss. Okay, first I'll select the field. Any field you can select, all the list of fields. You are connected the data model, right? Different tables you connected, right? Under the tables, what are the fields are there? All the list of fields are available here. What field you want required, you can choose it. I need to require ship country, for example. Yes, I'm selecting the field. Only it allows single column or single dimension. or single fill it allows. Okay, click on OK. Yes. Hip country, Argentina, Austria, Belgium, Brazil, Canada, Denmark, Finland, yes, all the things are there. Yes, you can see now. So here, so this is the, it allows. I want to record country, city, it's not possible. You can take the separate list boxes. So what is the definition of list box? A list box, it will use the, so all right, it will, it is a default sheet object. Why it will default, I'll tell you. Default sheet object, it allow single dimension or single column or single field, and it will use the unique values. So here, for example, Belgium was repeated 3 times in your database, but it will display it in, if you are using a list box, it will display it only one time. Okay, so that is a list box. Yes, now we'll see the tabs. We'll see the, what are the tabs are there. Yes, one sheet object you can thoroughly, you can learn. So almost all the sheet objects are same. Right click, properties. Yes, we have 8 tabs are there. General tab, expressions, sort, presentation, number, font, layout, caption. Okay, so general tab. Under the general tab, yes. So here by default you are not giving the any title. What is the column name is there, right? That one is automatically the title was given. If you are not given anything, so by default the column name is the ship country. So same name it was came in the title of the list box by default. If we give this one, I'll give the country any name, country information, I'll give it. If we give it automatically this one deselect, if you are enter any value in this title, it is automatically deselect. And so a list box, each object the separate ID was generated, each object the separate object was generated. So this is the unique ID was generated here. List box LB01 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 LB02 LB03 LB04 LB05 LB06 yes, it was came list box 01 02 03 04. Yes, so uniquely identified. So LB means list box 01 first object. Right now we'll go to the use as a title means column name. Yes, yeah, go ahead.
This number will be same for every sheet or it will be different for each sheet?
Each, so all right, I'll go to here. So this is the sheet, these are the sheets actually. Each sheet separate ID was generated. Under the, so under the sheet you are creating the objects. These are the list box, multi box, table box. So far, right, we are creating the list box. List box, so each object it was, right, list box is one object. Now if you create the another object, for example, if you go to the,
do it another sheet.
I'll go to here. For example, you take the multi box, for example. We'll discuss one by one, just you can see the ID MB. So multi box ID is the MB. Okay, so MB01. So now you are taking the one more list here, for example, list object you are taking the now city. Ship city. Now you can see now LB02. So here first object is the in this place. So entire document level it will give the IDs. Okay, unique ID only. Okay, okay. Now okay, we'll go to here properties. Sorry. LB01. So country information is here. The field name is the ship countries. Now right now we'll go to here. So use as a title means the column name is came to the, so all right, in the title show frequency, how many times it was repeated it will display it, how many times entire model wise, how many times Argentina 16 times, last year 40 times it was repeated, but it will display the in the list box only one time. That is show frequency, show alternate, show in percentage, nothing is happened. Okay, nothing, if you select or unselect, so nothing is happened. Okay, you can ignore it. Now hide and exclude, what is this one, we'll discuss before that one. I need to record Brazil and Canada. So Brazil and Canada, I want required as. What are the values selected? That one by default green color was given by default. So the selected values are, it will display it in green color, right? Now, so now go to the properties. So what values you are selected? So only that values, if you want to display it, remaining all the values you need to hide it, then you will go to the hide and exclude. Hide and exclude, yes. What values you are selected? So that values only it will display it. If unselected values, if you need to require, you can hide and exclude, yes. You will go to this one. You can hide and exclude. That is the hide and exclude. So far, you need to select single selection, multi-selection, everything is possible. Single selection and multi-selection, both are possible. Okay, what are the value you are selected? Why? Because so far, so the object is not in the read only. Okay, so I have selected this one. I'll give the property, I'll give the read only. So now, so I need to require Mexico information. It's not possible. Why? Because so this object, so what countries you need to require? I was selected and I gave the permission. Other things, if you want to add it, it's not possible. Why? Because this is just, you can see the output, that's it, read only option is there. That is the reason you are unable to. So if you give the read only, means you are not able to select the other values. That is the read only. That is the read only. Okay, that is the read only, right? Now, so here always one value selected, that one will go to here. So you can select single value, right? Until unless you need to uncheck read only, then only it's right. Now I want to require Brazil country, yes. You want to require, so far it allows single selection and multi-selection, both are allows. So here, so I don't want to require multi-selection, I want to require only always single selection, then you can select it. So if you want to require control button or shift button, it's not possible. Only single selection only it possible. I'll put a control button. Yes, it's selected only single values only. It was selected only single value. Okay, if you want to require, you can see now. It's single value only it allows. That is the always you need to require. You don't want to require multiple values, you can give the this one. Always single selection. So what is the override the locked field? For example, so here I need to require Brazil and Canada. These are the two countries information I want required. These are the two countries information I want required, Brazil and Canada, yes. Right, now, so these are the information I want required. I'll lock it. Here lock and unlock, two options are there. Lock and unlock. If you lock it, nobody can change it. If you click on lock, so it's not possible to select the other values until unless I was unlocked. So right, I was selected few countries, okay, Brazil and Canada data, I was lock it. So right, so users are able to see the only Brazil and Canada data. So other countries they cannot see it. Why? Because I was locked. So right, suddenly, so tomorrow I'm not feeling well, I'm not coming to the office, okay, I was already locked these two fields. So then they need to require US and UK data mandatory. They need to require very, very urgent requirement. They need to see the US and UK information. So then I was in sick, I'm not coming to the office. Okay, so then what I can do? Then what I can do? How we can? So right, until unless I will unlock. So then only they need to select the other countries. So then what you can do? They don't have permission to unlock it. Okay, the users, they don't have. Then what I can do? So right, so then here we'll go to the properties. Override the locked field. Override the locked field. Click on apply. Then you are able to select it other values also. So far, yes, you are able to select the other values. Other values you are able to select it. Okay, so right, instead of, so if you are locked, so if you are not giving the override locked field, you are unable to select the other countries. You are sick 5 days. Then the business is not waited 5 days. Then what you can do? You need to override the locked field. Then you can unlock. Then automatically all the fields are unlocked. Okay. So that is the override the locked fields. Override the locked fields. override the locked fields. Okay, that is the override locked fields. If you give
one question here.
Yeah.
What is the meaning of using this list box properties? Like, why do you list box properties?
So, for example, here, right? So, for this object, so here we can take the new sheet object one more. Then you can easily understand. I'll take the table box for example. I'll select all the fields. You can apply it. For example, what are the value you are selected based on that selection, that related detail information it was given. You can see.
Oh, okay.
So okay. For right, I'm explaining only one object. That is the reason. So right, all the option I'm explaining. Later, all the combine I'll show you. Okay, in the dashboard I'll show you. What are the value okay. selected? Then it will be changing the values. That is the general tab. Okay. Now we'll go to the properties. Okay, now so that is the, if you give the show tree view also, nothing is happened, so nothing is, you can ignore it, this one also. Right, now so you need to check the any values. We'll go to the, so here, so that is not required. This is the search mode. You need to record wildcard search, fuzzy search, normal search. By default, normal search. You need to record fuzzy search, you'll go to the fuzzy search. Here search option is there. Yes, you need to search it. A later, what are the things? S Mexico or anything. S Mexico or S letter. Okay, you need to select it, anything. So right, you can select it, anything you can select. Okay, anything you need to select it. So fuzzy, here different types of churches are there. Fuzzy church, so wildcard church. If you give the wildcard church, you know the entire field. So by default, church is there. Yes, I need to record a letter. Anywhere in a letter, starting or ending anywhere. Yes, all the letter. You need to record USA. Yes, anything. UK. Yes, anything. Okay, so properties. So override the, so that is the, what are the, by default it is a default search and normal search. Normal search means normal search. It was key. Okay, you can use the normal search. S letter, W letter, what you want to record, you can choose it. That is the first tab. That is the first tab. Okay, so here right, print all values. So if you want to record print, you can print all the values. Okay, that is the print all values, layout depending print. So these are the, nothing is required. That is the first tab. That is the general tab. Okay, now we'll go to the expression. In ClickView, so expressions are using only charts. Okay, only charts we need to use in expressions. So that is the reason we'll discuss with the expressions in, right, when are creating the any chart, one expression is mandatory. We'll discuss with under the charts. Under the chat, we'll discuss with expression related things. I'll back within 5 minutes, sir. So wait for 5 minutes. Okay, I'll back. I'll take the water and I'll back. Hello. Yeah, Rahman. Rahman, are you able to hear me? Yep. So, right.
Yes, I can hear you.
Yep. This expression tab we'll discuss with under the right in the chats we'll discuss. Now we'll go to the sort option. So generally, right in sorts, right. So any number wise, ascending order and descending order. Any text wise, A to Z and Z to A. So that is the common thing. So far, right, we'll go to the so text value. You don't have any numbers. That is the reason we are not going to. If you go to the numbers, so then ascending order or descending order. Ascending order and descending order. So text value, so A to Z and Z to A. Either. So you will go to the A to Z and Z to A. Yes. Either way. You'll go to the A to Z and Z to A. So if you want required frequency ascending and descending order, if you want required, you can apply it. So you can apply that values also, you can apply it. You can ascending order if you want to frequency wise ascending order. Okay, so here, so we'll give the text value in the right, you'll go to them. So right, if you want frequency ascending order, if you are giving the descending order, you can give the descending order. So the value is the highest value. Okay, now if you don't want to require that one, so I need to require text wise A to Z. Yes, first A letter. If you give the, that is a common thing. Everybody know these things. So after this, these are the ascending order and descending order. These are sort orders are common. But in Clickio, so load order is there. This is the, when we'll go to this one, I'll give you the example. Load order. So load order, original order, or reverse order is there. Okay, so now I'll take the one Excel file. For example, I'm using as a source an Excel file. So month name. For example, revenue. These are the values. Month name wise revenue. Right. I imported this Excel file as a source. Now, so here I'm arranging the ascending order. So in the text wise, I'm arranging the so A to Z or Z to A. So I've arranged this one. If I arrange the A to Z, what happened? So the first month was came. So month wise revenue, right? You need to take the table box, for example, month. The first starting month is the April. So the data, it will display the April. April data. Next, August data it will display. If you are arranging the ascending order. Next, it will display the February. December data, next February data it will display, yes. So, right, it will display the, this is the way it will display it, if you are arranging the ascending order. But, so client is asking, yes, so Hari, could you please show me, so A to, means January to December or December to January, you can, either way, you will go ahead and you can show, this is the way, not this is a very difficult, okay, then what I can do? So you are inputted any type of files. Okay, what happened? If you arrange in the ascending order, by default ascending order was came. Ascending order means this is the way the data it will display it. So right, April, August, so December, February, this is right. So nobody can, so it is not right, correct way. So then what we can do? So that is the reason Clicky was give the some option. Original order and reverse order. Any type of files if you are imported, you can use the original order means as it is. January to December data it will display it. If any type of, if you want required reverse order means December to January, the data it will display it. That will happen. That will happen. So that is the, okay, that is the option. Any queries? Clear, Rahman?
No, I'm okay.
Now,
Yeah, okay.
right, now we'll go to the presentation. When we'll go to this one, load order means any type of files, Excel file, CSV file, text file, anything you are using as a source, then only you can use it this one. So next, presentation. Next, we'll go to the presentation, okay. Under the presentation, right, now we'll go to the presentation. Here, I'll go to the, so text, left side or right side, or corner, center, what you want record, you can choose it. You need to move it to the text, right corner, left corner, yes, you can move it. Okay, that is the default. If you have numbers also there, if you numbers by default, right corner side is there. If you want record, you can move it. That is the common thing. You need to record by default, text is there. If you want record, you can text. Any image, if you want record, you can choose the image. That is the common thing. Now here, so different styles are there. These styles you can use it. So these are the, so style is there. Click your classic, that one. Windows checkboxes. You need to record window checkboxes. Yes, the styles are there. You need to select what are the value you want record, you can select it. That is the window checkboxes. Window checkboxes. So you need to select it, window checkboxes. So corner tag. Instead of that one, you need to record corner tag. The tags, what are the selected values, green color, the tag was, tags are came. These are all are predefined. So LED checkbox, LED. So this is the LED, just LED only. So you are, right? You are selected anything? Yes, one single selection only tell. LED checkbox. Here, so you can, most common using option is the, if any time in real time you are using, so in list box, everybody can using LED checkbox. It allows, so the only LED, it allows single selection only. LED checkbox means it allows single selection and color was, both are came. Yes, we can choose it. So this is the most common useful option. Okay, most common useful option. That is the LED checkbox. If any time in your dashboard you are using in list box, yes, you are using this common option is a common. Next, so for all the values are, it will display it single column. Now I want required. So all right, instead of single column, I need to require fixed number of column. Two columns I want required. The data, it will display the two columns, fixed number of columns. If you want required, you will go to that one. If you don't want required, you will go to the this one. Okay, the scroll bar was came. Okay, next, order by column. So far if you select or unselect, nothing has happened. We'll discuss some dashboard that time we are using order by column. We'll discuss that time. Cell borders, lines are came. The lines are came, borders. Okay, so cell borders. Highlighted church substring. So far if you select any USC, if you want required, for example, it was highlighted, the blue, so yellow color, it was highlighted. So that one, if you don't want required, highlighted set substring, so you can unselect it. Nothing has happened. Nothing has happened. The color was not came. The color was not came. Properties. Okay, order by column. Okay, now highlighted substring. So here, wrap text lines, here each value, the gap was one line. You can select it, apply, one line. Now I will give the two lines. You can increase it. You can give the gaps between the values, yes, you can increase it. You can increase it, yes, you can increase it. So that is the, if you don't want to record, only one. That is the thing. Number tab. So here, number tab, you need to change the settings. You need to require a date format, you need to require money format, any type of, so changes in the data types. So date is alright, MMYYDD is there. You need to require some other change, yes, you'll go to that one. You need to require percentage, yes, you can go to the percentage. Any a date field or a time field, money is there. So money rupees are there. You need to change the dollar or pound, yes, you'll go to here. So alright, number, you need to require number or decimals or percentage, yes. What are the changes if you want required? You need to change it in this place only. You need to change it. You need to change it. Yes, you need to change the format. What you need to require? You need to change the format. You need to change the format. Okay. So you need to change the format. You need to change it. These are the formats. Okay. Now, so, all right. This is the, we'll discuss all the things I'll show you. Once I'll take the measures, then I'll show you these values. Okay, next font, you can change the font size, you can increase the size. So right, you want to what are the thing you want required, you can choose it. You need to increase the size. If you want required, you can increase it. If you don't want required, yes, you'll go to the this style. Yes, what you want required, you need required. Drop down line, sorry, so shadow, underline. If you want required, you can give the underline also. What you want required, you can use it, you can use it. That is the font style, font style. Okay, that is the thing. So layout, okay, layout and these two things I'll explain and tomorrow, sir. So now I have some doctor appointment is there. I'll so tomorrow, so please I'll take the 1.5 hour session now. Okay, so okay, so I'll up to this one you can practice it, sir. These two tabs I'll explain on tomorrow, sir. Okay.
Okay, sure.
Okay, thanks. Fine, see you, bye. Vastanag, my name is Arkeli Chupichukuntana.